Hi guys, welcome to this video. In this video, we are going to create a golf ball using Curve Parametric. So let's get started. At first, click on new and unclick the default or use the default template and enter the part name as golf ball. Click on OK. So at first, I'm going to sketch the front plane. So go for the sketch, select the front plane, it will automatically go for the right reference. Go for the sketch. And go for the sketch view. So here at first I am going to draw a circle, and then I am going to draw a center line, which is must for the revolve option. I am going to use revolve tool for this. So then let's adjust this diameter as 42.70. So then I am going to cut these three parts. So at first I am going to draw a line from here to the center point and towards this tangent. Now delete all these lines. So now sketch is got completed. So now click on OK. So now I am going to use revolve tool for this. So as you can see, our part is got revolved successfully. So then click on OK. So now I am going to add another sketch for this, as here around material as a remove material feature. So for that, I am going to sketch the front plane again as a reference of right. Go for the sketch, go for the sketch view. At first, here I am going to draw a center line here. I am going to use revolve tool again for this cut. Go for the reference, select this circle and this circle as a reference edge. Close it. So here I am going to draw an arc, zoom it like this. Select 3-point tangent arc, select here, select here. Leave it like this. Then go for the dimensions, select this point and this center line and enter a length of 2.25 and select this point and this point and enter a height of 1. Then I am going to draw a line from here to here as a horizontal line and go for the tangent. Make this line and this circle as a tangent, then delete this line. So now our sketch is got completed. So I am going to use revolve tool for this. So now we are going to complete this sketch by drawing a lines here. Draw a line to this references and go for the project, select this line, close it, go for the delete the unwanted segments and go for the select. You can see the pink color, our sketch is got fully constrained. So now click on OK. Now I am going to revolve this part. Go for the revolve. As you can see, it is extruded successfully. So then click on OK. So now I am going to pattern this hole. So select this revolve, go for the pattern, go for the axis pattern, hide all those datum planes and make only CSYS display. So here I am going to select this Z axis and I am going to enter the members as 2 and enter the angle between members as 15. I need it in this direction, go for the flip and then click on OK. As you can see, our part is got completed. So I am going to select this part, go for the geometry pattern, go for the axis, select this axis again, enter the number of 2 and enter an angle of 15, flip the direction and then click on OK. We need to repeat this for 7 holes. Go for the axis, select this axis, enter the same value and same angle that we entered for the last part and don't forget to flip this. You need to select the last created revolve pattern. So now all our parts are created, our pattern parts like this, in this direction. So now I am going to repeat this for all the sides. So it's an easy process. So now I am going to select the second hole, go for the geometry pattern, go for the axis pattern, and click the display and go for the axis display. Select this center axis and you enter the number of 6 here with an angle between members as 60. So you can see here a part is got created, and then click on OK. So now click on the third hole, go for the geometry pattern, select this as axis pattern, select this axis, and here I am going to enter the number of members as 12, and I am going to enter an angle of 30 here, and then click on OK. So now select this hole, go for the geometry pattern, select the axis or the same axis, and enter the number as 18, and enter a angle of 20 here, then click on OK. Then select the next hole, go for the geometry pattern, go for the axis, select this axis, and here I am going to enter a value of 21 with an angle of 360 divided by 21 as 17.1, then click on OK. Select this, go for the geometry pattern, axis pattern, axis with a number of 24 with an angle of 360 divided by 24 as 15, click on OK. And then select this last, go for the geometry pattern, select axis, this center axis with a number of 27 with an angle of 360 divided by 27, then click on OK. So now all our parts are regenerated successfully. So now I am going to mirror this towards downwards. So select all this, select the only plane display, and now simple this path by clicking this. So now select this revolve and all these patterns. So now go for the mirror, select the bottom plane. So this may take time, as we created more patterns, as 12 number of patterns, it may take time to regenerate. Or else you can create this part by drawing a full circle as a revolve part, and you need to repeat this whole dimensions for all this entire circle, or else it is an easy process for us as we are using the mirror tool. As you can see here, our mirror part is done successfully, then click on OK. So now, as you can see the sharp edges here, so I am going to round, so hide all those datum planes and go for the auto round feature and select the convex as 0.90 and then click on OK. It may take some time to regenerate, or else it will miss some object. For regenerating, we need to create some round features for that. As you can see here, all our parts are created except this round. So go for the round again. So the enter value as 0.90 and select all these circles Select the edge of the circles. You need to select this edge. Make sure all our circles are regenerated successfully, or else you need to do like this. So now I create a round feature for all our paths. Click on OK. So now our golf ball is got completed. So I'm going to give some appearances for this. So here I'm going to give some legacy color for this as metal color. Go for the shading with reflections. As you can see here, our path is got completely done. So thanks for watching, guys. So if you want more videos related to mechanical engineering or any other content, you can comment below. And if you are new to our channel, don't forget to subscribe to get new videos. And don't forget to like this video, guys.